This is Real News Media TV, coverage you can trust. Please like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Select all for daily news updates. Seaview Gardens mother and son missing. Police in St. Andrew are seeking the public's assistance to find 40-year-old Kamisha Smith and her 11-year-old son Shamar Williams, both of Yellow Sea Drive, Seaview Gardens, Kingston 11, who have been missing since Sunday, February 7. She is of brown complexion, stout build, and about 162 centimeters tall, while Shamar is of dark complexion, stout build, and about 132 centimeters tall. Reports are that Smith and her son were last seen at home about 1 p.m. Smith's mode of dress at the time she went missing was a blue skirt and a pink t-shirt, while Shamar was wearing a blue shorts and white merino. All efforts to contact Smith have failed. Anyone knowing the whereabouts of Kamisha Smith and Shamar Williams is asked to contact the Seaview Gardens Police at 876-997-9372, Police 119 emergency number, or the nearest police station. Hotel worker from St. Andrew missing. Sean Basco, a hotel worker of Lawrence Tavern, St. Andrew, has been missing since Thursday, February 4. He is of dark brown complexion, stout build, and about 183 centimeters tall. Reports from the Halfway Tree Police are that Basco was last seen at about 9 p.m. boarding a bus at the transport center in Halfway Tree. He has not been heard from since. When last seen, he was dressed in a black shirt, black jeans, and a pair of black and white sneakers. Anyone knowing the whereabouts of Sean Basco is being asked to contact the Halfway Tree Police at 876-926-8185, Police 119 emergency number, or the nearest police station. Bike rider dies from motorcycle crash in Westmoreland. A bike rider is dead and another hospitalized following a motor collision at Bog Square in Westmoreland on Sunday, February 7. The deceased has been identified as 26-year-old Arnold Cornaldi of Newworks in the parish. Reports from the Whitehouse Police are that about 12:50 p.m., two motorcyclists were traveling in opposite directions along the roadway. On reaching a section of the road, the driver of the Purple Champion motorcycle lost control of the vehicle he was operating and ended up colliding into a Red Champion motorcycle that was being driven by Cornaldi. Both men were taken to hospital, where Cornaldi was pronounced dead and the other driver was admitted in serious condition. Investigations continue into the fatal collision. Cops hold St. James man who allegedly raped a 7-year-old and gave her $120 in hush money. A 40-year-old St. James man who reportedly raped a 7-year-old girl and later gave her $120 to keep the incident a secret has been apprehended by the police after being on the run for almost 2 months. It was reported by the police that the man has reportedly confessed to the crime. The accused, a Mason, was apprehended by members of the Freeport Special Task Force during an operation in the community of Maroontown in Springmount, St. James on Tuesday. The police reported that on the day of the incident, the child who was visiting a relative was sitting on the veranda when she was approached by the man who is known to her. The attacker allegedly held onto her hand and carried her to the rear of the house, removed her clothing, and sexually assaulted her before giving her $120 not to tell anyone. However, as soon as the relative returned to the yard, the girl reported the matter to her and was taken to the police station. The accused man has been in hiding since and managed to elude previous police dragnets. Boy stabbed over cell phone in hospital. The Westmoreland police have launched a manhunt for a man who reportedly stabbed a minor outside of the Westmoreland Parish Court in Savannah Lamar on Tuesday morning. Investigators say they have not yet ascertained the suspect's identity. Reports are that the 14-year-old boy traveled with his dad in a motor truck to the court where the father had a pending case. The boy was left inside the truck, which was parked behind the courthouse. Shortly after 10:30 a.m., he answered a call on his phone. A man armed with a knife crept up beside the truck and attempted to snatch the cell phone from his hand, but the boy resisted the robber, who stabbed him repeatedly. Several eyewitnesses ran to his rescue, and the attacker dropped the knife on the roadway and fled the scene on foot. The police and the boy's father were called to the scene, and the wounded child was taken to the Savannah Lamar Hospital, where he was admitted in serious condition. Head of the Westmoreland Police, Superintendent Robert Gordon, states that the child could have lost his life over a cell phone. This is another instance where persons need to be very vigilant and observe their surroundings, Gordon said. Luckily, the child in question is sturdily built and he managed to fight off the robber, although he was seriously stabbed. The police intend to scour surveillance footage in the area to track the robber. Robbers hit Whitehouse Credit Union. For the second time in less than 7 months, armed robbers posing as customers carried out a daring daylight multi-million-dollar robbery at a financial institution in the community of Whitehouse in Westmoreland. The latest incident took place approximately 12:30 Tuesday afternoon at the Community and Workers of Jamaica Cooperative Credit Union located along Main Street in the fishing community. Reports by the police are that six men entered the credit union, held up the security guard at gunpoint, and stole an estimated Jamaican $5 million in cash. They escaped in two motor cars. Superintendent Robert Gordon, commanding officer for Westmoreland, said on Tuesday that the police are on the trail of the gunmen and are hoping to make an early arrest. No one was hurt, but the robbers made off with the guard's firearm and the complete surveillance apparatus, in that they would have taken the VCR setup for the institution, which makes it harder to identify and track them, Gordon said. The Westmoreland police commander said that robbers were venturing into small communities and targeting financial institutions and other businesses that have a high cash turnover. While urging the credit union to beef up security operations, Gordon cautioned other financial entities to be on the lookout for thieves posing as customers. He also advised the business owners to position their security cameras and servers in hard-to-reach areas. In late July 2020, gunmen pulled off a daylight robbery at the Jamaica National Bank in Whitehouse and made off with several million dollars. Earlier this year, armed men posing as customers also went into the Quarter Ready Cash Finance outlet in Negril, Westmoreland, and robbed tellers of an undetermined sum of money. Elderly woman killed in Manchester crash. An elderly woman is now dead following a motor vehicle accident along the Greenville Main Road in Manchester yesterday. She has been identified as Edna Whiteley of a Warwick address in the parish. According to reports, at approximately 12:30 p.m., a Toyota Probox taxi was traveling along the Greenville Main Road heading onto the Winston Jones Highway when its driver overtook a truck. The driver lost control of the vehicle and crashed in a median along the road. Whiteley, a passenger in the vehicle, was rushed to the hospital where she was pronounced dead. The driver of the motor vehicle is currently hospitalized. The police say they have not yet ascertained if there were other passengers in the vehicle. Superintendent of the Manchester Police, Gary Francis, is appealing to motorists to adhere to the road code, specifically for the speed limit, to avoid road fatalities. Holiness announces new curfew hours for Jamaica. Prime Minister Andrew Holiness has announced changes to the containment measures as the country deals with the spread of COVID-19. Effective today, February 10, the island-wide curfew will commence at 8 p.m. and end at 5 a.m. daily. This new curfew will be in effect until February 24, 2021. The announcement was made in Parliament yesterday. Public gatherings have also been reduced from 15 to 10 people. If we don't act now, we could overwhelm the health system, Holiness said. He added that the government will adjust the restrictions once the COVID cases decrease. Holiness stated that a ticketing legislation for violation of curfew hours and quarantine orders will be brought before Parliament in the upcoming weeks. On Monday, Jamaica recorded its highest number of COVID-19 cases in a 24-hour period, with 403 cases recorded from 1,935 samples tested in the last 24 hours. The breakdown of COVID-19 bed spaces in South Central Jamaica are as follows: Mandeville Regional Hospital, 15 occupants. occupied, 5 available. Percy Juno Hospital, 6 occupied, 10 available. Maypen Hospital, 19 occupied, 7 available. Lionel Town Hospital, 7 occupied, 4 available. And Black River, 7 occupied, 16 available. Please remember to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Select all for daily news updates.